Across the country, thousands of farming families work tirelessly around the clock.
Stop arguing, girls. Give over.
But there's one day each year when they get to leave the daily routine behind.
Right, here we come, Dorset.
These are show days.
A very, very warm welcome to Malpas Show.
When they come together as a community to showcase the fruits of their labour.
I just love showing my girls off.
And try to win prizes for their breed champions.
Smashed it.
And award-winning produce.
That's a really nice cheese, that.
It was very good, darling.
There will be highs.
That's what we want to see, red. Red is the best.
And lows.
She's not happy enough to go.
For the dedicated farmers who give everything to walk away a champion.
Fingers crossed.
Cattle farming is one of the most traditional forms of farming in the UK. Today we're meeting two families whose lifeblood is connected to their herds. Beef cattle farmers Robert and Sandy Tedbury from Sussex and Hertfordshire-based Bridget Borlays are busy preparing for one of the largest cattle championships in the country.
Come on, go on, Jen.
Winning awards helps boost the reputation of their livestock and their business, so there's a lot at stake.
Head up.
All year has been leading up to this event, and both families have their eyes on the prize. Rural Hertfordshire is home to hundreds of farms. And Bridget's family have been working this farm for five generations.
I always loved the cows. When I came back from school, my father said, well, that's where your passion is. You know, get on and you run that side of the business.
Having grown up on the farm, Bridget now lives there with her own family.
Wave to him, Sammy.
And five-year-old son Sam already has farming in his blood.
I'm already five, and when I'm six, I'm going to trim my sheep on my own.
It is, Sam, yeah.
The farm has been in the family for 80 years, and breeding cattle has always been close to Bridget's heart.
My passion, right from when I was probably Sam's age, was pedigree livestock. I always loved the cows.
Bridget's grandfather, Bert, first introduced the Simmental cattle to the farm, and now Bridget has grown the much-loved herd to 250.
I spent more time reading the herd books of how the cattle were bred than I ever did studying at school.
To manage a farm this size takes much dedication, and Bridget is up at dawn every day, relying on her farm buggy to get her around.
It's one thing as a farmer, we spend as much time driving in reverse as we do going forward, sort of thing. So it's always really annoying when you meet people on the road that on a narrow lane that can't reverse. So it's always a bit of a standing joke with farmers that the driving test should be done in reverse.
Bridget spent her life on this farm, but this devoted cattle farmer can't get enough of it.
I know all the names of the cows, probably more than all my friends' names, but I do. My other half, James, thinks it's slightly sad, but he likes cutting them up in the butchery.
The reason James likes cutting up the meat is because he's a butcher. While Bridget is busy in the fields, James is running the family's two butcher's shops, selling meat from their own cattle.
Orders come in to me from any time, from 9 o'clock at night through till midnight, very often beyond, and we start at 6 o'clock in the morning.
The couple first opened the butcher's shop 10 years ago to try to boost business after the foot and mouth outbreak.
It completely knocked the UK livestock industry for six, really. Many, many farms were sort of struggling, particularly the sort of family farms, as we are. So we were looking for something to diversify into. Had no idea, really, you know, what we'd be good at or what we should do. But by chance, really, our local council encouraged us to think about selling our own meat. We hadn't really got a clue what we were doing, but we were sort of guided by an ex-butcher who said he'd help us out, and it snowballed from there, really.
We supply in the region of 20, 25 retail outlets, anything from restaurants right the way through to just little cafes. Today we're delivering pork, lamb and beef. We had one restaurant that rang us up urgently, can you supply six sirloin steaks? We were closed. So, yeah, how soon do you need them? We're serving starters now. So I had about a 15-minute turnaround from the call to get six sirloin steaks to a restaurant. We did it. Got it done. Great feedback.
Morning, guys. How are we?
Morning.
Morning, Tom.
Morning, Vlad.
Yeah, fine, thank you. Vlad, there you go. Paul, thank you, my friend. So this is Tom, chef owner. Multi-talented chef. He's nearly as good as me, actually, but I taught him all he knew, knows. They think they work as hard as we do, but I think we can beat them.
Eighty miles away in Sussex, farmers Robert and Sandy have been up since 6 a.m., tending to their 440-acre farm. There's an endless list of daily jobs.
Good girl, Iris. Hello, sweetie.
I think with farming, definitely they say it's in your blood. And I think that's right, because it's not a 9-to-5 job.
Unlike Bridget and James, who diversified to boost business, Robert and Sandy have to rely on the income they make from breeding.
I am 7 days a week, 365 days a year. I cannot afford to employ anybody. The income that I can make from what I do will not service another full-time or even part-time person. I do what we can manage without employing help.
As well as working on the farm, Sandy sometimes supplements the family income with a little part-time cleaning. That leaves Robert to deal with the day-to-day running of the farm. As a modern-day cowboy, he has the tricky task of rounding up 100 cattle, not on a horse, but in a 4x4.
Hello, boy. Pedigree Aberdeen Angus, 8 years old, born and bred in Oxfordshire. Great Chew Jericho, he's called.
He has to move them round between fields to make sure they graze evenly.
Come on!
It's a huge undertaking that he has to perform alone.
Come on, come on! I gotta go and protect my Land Rover now because they'll decimate it. Go on! Go on!
But with cattle weighing up to 1,000 kilograms, rolling up a herd can be dangerous work. In Britain alone, they've been responsible for over 75 deaths in the last 15 years.
That's what happened to quite a heavy, robust gate with two bulls, one each side, wanting to get to each other. They didn't get to one each other, but they broke the hinge and made the gate look like baker foil. Good girl.
As well as dealing with his own herd, Robert also has to look after Sandy's pride and joy, her Highlands.
Come on, girl. This way. Come on. I saw my first Highland 35 plus years, actually more than that, I think. We were up in Scotland. I just thought they were beautiful. I love the long hair, I love their big horns. I just fell in love with them. So I then started collecting China Highlands.
But Robert wanted to take Sandy's collection one step further.
I decided that I'd buy the wife a couple calves. I think it was anniversary present. It could have been birthday, but...
No, it was anniversary. To actually have the real thing, it was all my Christmases in one. That is one of their favourite places, have been brushed.
I could always sell them if we split up and parted, so we kept the animals and they were Highlands.
And their numbers have grown from 2 to 50. Sandy just can't resist them.
If a Highland animal at a sale licks her hand, it's in. It's coming home. Just got to lick her hand. That's all it's got to do. It could kick her, but as long as it licks her hand, she's coming home.
It's not quite like that.
Back in Hertfordshire, Bridget is nervously waiting for the local vet, who works with over 100 farms in the region.
Hello, how are you?
Hello, I thank you, how are you?
She suspects one of her prize-winning cows, who is off to the show, might be pregnant. Something she's been hoping for.
Getting her bred hasn't been as straightforward as it normally is. Every time she's been in season has been when we've been away from home at a show or something. We'll be over the moon if we have a positive result. So it's fingers crossed that she's taken.
So I'm just scanning with an ultrasound scanner, like humans do.
A calf from a champion mother is worth a lot to the farm, as they can sell for thousands of pounds.
She's pregnant.
That's really good news that she's in calf, and like, oh, thank God for that.
Just checking for twins now, make sure there's nothing.
About 10% of our calvings would be twins. We did have a set of triplets last year, but that's exceptionally rare.
So yeah, just the one in there. Like I say, heartbeat, so it's a live fetus. Taking a picture as well.
Thank you.
It's a great result for the farm, but the prized mum-to-be is already carrying a few extra pounds in preparation for the show, which is not ideal.
Especially fed to go to shows. It takes 6 months, really, to feed a cow, to have it in perfect condition. You're looking to get a bit more roundness and shape. Build it up slowly. If you try and, you know, feed them very hard, quite quickly, all you get is lumps of fat, which isn't what we want.
We like them to be, we say fit, not fat, and unfortunately, show condition is on the fat side.
On fat.
Yes, she is a little bit chunkier than I would like.
She's just gearing up for the big diet. I'm going to join her.
With the pregnancy confirmed, Bridget can now focus on the all-important show day.
Going to these shows is our, for the cattle, our shop window. Bridget spends hours getting them to a certain specification.
It's only 24 hours to go, and her cows have to look their best to impress.
First impressions as a judge are very important. You want an animal to immediately hit you when it comes into the ring that, yeah, I like that, I wouldn't mind taking that one home. If we can win some prizes, it can add value to that animal, it can add value to that animal's progeny. We're all vying for that silverware. They're set with hairspray. They smell great on show day. These cows have as much money spent on their hair care in a year as I do.
Back over in Sussex, show day preparations are also in full swing, with prize-winning cow Gem, the apple of Sandy's eye...
Hello, you like that.
..being given a wash and brush up.
She's my favourite. I suppose because I started with her in the very beginning, so I've done all the training with her. The best bit about Gem is what we call homebred, so she's my own breeding. If you're lucky enough to win with a homebred, it feels even nicer.
To be a winner at the show, it's all down to what the judges think.
Nothing's guaranteed, but one judge will pick one animal, another judge will pick a totally different animal. There may not be very much between them, but the judge is always going to be right on the day, even when he's wrong.
Right or wrong, for Sandy, it's all about showing people her beloved Highlands.
I got to say, of course I like to win, but part of it, I love, just love showing my girls off. They're just beautiful.
For Robert, coming first is everything.
We'd like to win. I don't do it to be there. All this money and all this time we've spent, we have to go and do everything to the best of our ability to win.
With the big day tomorrow, it's finally time to get the show on the road. But this is a challenge in itself.
Some of these have been to shows and they're seasoned campaigners and they'll, we hope, load quite easily. Some haven't been at all before, so it can sometimes be a little tricky.
It's Gladiator the Bull's first time away from the farm, so he's a little cautious. Bridget's son Sam is keeping well away.
It's always a bit tense loading up, making sure that they get on all right.
We take our own hay, because we know where it's come from. It's been made here. So they'll go to the show and they'll be on exactly the same food.
Meanwhile, Bridget's still struggling with Gladiator.
Bring the passports down. They're just to the left of my chair. Paperwork, paperwork, paperwork. Paperwork has to go with the animals. Each animal's got a passport. The only thing it hasn't got, like yours, is a picture.
And Gladiator's finally on board. It's now time for the rest.
All right, you get Farah, then.
I will hopefully be going down for a day, which I'm not too bothered about, although she does get a little touchy over it. They get up really early, pretending to fluff them and talcum powder them and make them smell nice. And I can just stay up and make sausages. It's easier.
Drive steady, you got valuable property on there.
Safely on board, all Gladiator and the other cattle can do now is to get their beauty sleep ready for tomorrow's show. Today, the Edenbridge and Oxted Agricultural Show will open its doors. home to one of the largest cattle championships in the country, this prestigious event is a highlight of the farming calendar. Most of those competing have camped at the showground overnight. But there's no time for a lie-in on show day, with so much to do.
You want them to look nice, and to go out with a dirty bottom wouldn't look right. So they go out with clean bottom.
Robert and Sandy have been up since 4 a.m., making sure their cattle look the part for the show ring.
I'm apprehensive, I'm nervous, because when you look in the shed, you think, oh, is that one better than mine? Is that going to beat me? So you're nervous that you're going to make the very best job for your animal and for your business at home. You're going to show your cattle off to the very best of your ability on the day, and you don't really know whether you've done that until it's finished.
Bridget has also been up bright and early.
I left the children with my parents in the caravan at 5 this morning. I managed to creep out and come down here to give the cattle their breakfast. It's the lull before the storm. Always nervous on show morning. You've got butterflies in your tummy. You're kind of anxious as to how you're going to get on. Competition's looking fairly strong this morning. Fingers crossed that we're going to do okay, but you never know.
As competition time approaches, spectators are starting to fill the showground. Around 40,000 people are expected at the show to experience the very best of Surrey's country life.
Everybody going very nicely out there.
With judging starting in less than an hour, Robert is giving the last-minute touches to their Highland hopefuls.
Get the parting down through the middle, get it straight and get it tidy. Shining up the horns, it's just baby oil. Horns are an important part of the Highland animal. Sweeping up for girls, sweeping around for boys. It's just finishing off the finer detail, that's all it is really.
So last minute spray and the combing and brushing, and then going out, you'll see that we'll do their feet. That's the very last thing we do. And then up to the show ring. And fingers crossed.
Over in the other pen, Bridget's also doing some final sprucing up.
We've got about 6 different shades of soap, and we try and match it as best possible with the actual animal's natural hair colour. Quite nervous now, it always is. It's all a bit of a rush just the hour before judging.
Yeah, we won't be talking to you in the last half an hour. You can look and see and that's it.
Morning, Bridget.
Ah, morning, you're here.
At last? Which hopefully means I've missed all the hard work.
No, it doesn't. You can help me soak this one up.
Oh, joy.
Farmers have been showing their prized animals at the show since the middle of the 19th century.
The show's been running for well over 175 years now. Edenbridge has a fantastic reputation for really high-quality livestock entries, and to win classes here is something that many of our exhibitors aspire to every year, to win awards that help them go on to improve the saleability of their stock. But it's not just about the livestock. We've got a superb display of vintage cars, tractors. We've got our fairground, food hall, where people can try different local produce. All the sort of things that you might associate with the countryside.
It's 9 a.m. and this year's cattle competition is about to begin. Both families have done everything they can.
Hold her there, say stop.
Stop. My tummy's going, I'm feeling sick. The fear, I suppose, of letting my animal down. I think that's why, I don't know. I just wish I never had nerves, but I do.
Months of planning, feeding and grooming have all come down to this moment.
How are you getting on then, Bridget?
Yeah, nearly ready to go, just final titivating. Zimmies have started, so we're pretty much ready to rock.
While Bridget waits for her moment, in the Highland Ring, it's showtime for Sandy. She's taking in her pride and joy, Jen.
Wait. Right, can I come out? No. Ooh. No, good girl.
There's just time for a quick pep talk before she goes in the ring. And into the ring they go. Judging the Highland cattle today will be Archie McCarthy.
Well, a Highland cow, you know pretty quickly an animal has got personality or not.
Stand.
Archie is looking for a beefy body and a good coat of hair.
You want a Highland cow to be good in its legs, lift its legs up, and you want a set of horns that are going to come out symmetrically in the top of her head, make her look graceful.
Jem is up against three others.
Steady. It's okay.
But it's not looking good.
It's okay. We're not being very good.
Oh, we're not.
No.
Oh, well, don't worry.
Good.
Coming into new surroundings and different people is all quite strange to them. So you have to take that into account when you're looking at them and give them as much help as you can. Yeah?
Good girl. Walk on. Come on. Good girl.
Finally, Archie's picked his winner. And it's Jem who takes first prize. But Sandy is distracted and doesn't realise.
Hello.
Oh, sorry.
Hello.
Oh, now she's on my stick. It's all going wrong. Oh, God.
Oh, how embarrassing.
How embarrassing. As well.
I thought that she's a good animal, well balanced for her age, and I thought, oh, this will might do, and sure enough, as the show went on, she did do.
Sandy couldn't be happier with her beloved Jem.
Yes! We've done things wrong, but anyway, we've still got a red one. So, excellent, yeah. Good girl. Right, thank you.
And there's more good news, as Jem's sister, Cara, has also come top of her class.
Yes. Well done. I love my cows, but I do love my husband. Without him, none of this would be happening. So I need to, yes, he's number one.
Now the spotlight is on Bridget. Her judge today is fellow farmer Andy Ryder.
As soon as they come in the ring, I'm going to be looking at something what stands out, you know, and says, look at me, really, and, you know, and then you go for more of the finer points after that. From its head back right down to its tail head, you want a good width down its top line, and then when you get to the rear end of it, you want a good shape, especially on the bulls. You want something with meat, really, so.
Bridget's also been a judge herself and knows what they want. Now she just has to see if her cow Farah will tick all the boxes.
Yeah, she's keen, eager to go, so off we go.
Though they have stiff competition, as they're up against a former national champion.
All right, Jim.
Jimmy McMillan. Bit of a legend in the beef showing world. Jimmy and I are great friends. We have been for years, but we're always vying to sort of just try and sneak one on the other one.
Jimmy aside, Bridget has another four competitors to try and beat today.
Good morning. She's June born.
June born. Shin calf.
April calving.
Sudden noises can spook the animals at the big shows, so the farmers all use a stick to tickle the animals' tummies and keep them happy. Bridget is desperately hoping her pregnant show cow Farah will beat her main rival. But it's not to be, as Jimmy does it again. And Bridget takes second place.
Bridget's heifer was tremendous, but just not as the power of the first one, but still full of the characteristics of the Simmental breed.
As Jimmy's winner takes its lap of victory...
Fair play to Jimmy, it's a really lovely heifer.
It's back to the pen for Bridget.
Farah is 6 months younger than the one that won. That makes a big difference in terms of their size and development. So she's really held her own, and I'm really chuffed to bits with her. Let's hope it gets a little better, but it's a really good start to the day.
Show days attract the farming community and those who have never stepped foot on a field in their lives. However, for the farmers, it's not just about winning prizes. They work all hours, and this is a chance to spend some quality time together as a family.
We had some of those.
Which
when
is
I
our
was favourite
your
age,
one there,
we
Samuel.
Had a 135 and a 165. They're about 60 years old, Sam.
Taking a well-earned break from the judging, Bridget, James and son Sam have headed straight for the tractor display.
OK, so which one's this one, Sam?
Well, that's a new one. And right over there, there's a really, really old one.
Look at that. And how old's that, Jerry?
It's a 1908, and that's one of the first tractors after the horse. We're here at the show today to show people how farming was done back in the day.
Well, look, you used to sit on there. Sit down there.
Yeah.
And look at that. You needed big muscles for that.
It's important that children and adults, to a certain extent, understand where their food comes from and how it gets produced.
That's your old combine harvester. Yeah, that's right.
Machines like these would go on to revolutionise the farming industry. 87-year-old tractor enthusiast Tony remembers only too well how different farming used to be.
Times have changed. We used to do everything with horses in those days. We used to get by. It was a slower pace of life, but we got the job done. In 1939, I was 10 years old. My grandfather was on his deathbed, and he said to me, he said, Tony, he said, in your time, he said, you're going to see some marvellous things. He said, in my time, I've seen some marvellous things, but nothing like you're going to see in your time, and it's happened. And I say to my grandchildren, in your lifetime, you're going to see marvellous things, the same as I have.
What do you think, Samuel? Is it like our tractor? No? Is it different?
Well, in little Sam's eyes, these modern-day tractors are certainly marvellous. So much so, he tries to strike a deal to take one home.
Sam?
Lock you for all of our cows and we take the tractor.
Do you want the keys now?
Yeah.
Yeah,
here
again.
That's the best deal we've had, actually.
That was a good deal, wasn't it, Sam?
Yeah, taking the case.
Wow, let's go and see the rabbits.
I hope he hasn't locked the case.
Breaks over and judging is back in full swing. In the Highland show ring, it's the final showdown for husband and wife, Robert and Sandy. They're going head-to-head with their prize-winning cows, Jem and sister Cara, for the prestigious Best of Breed title. And the pressure is on.
We would love to achieve champion Highland animal. If we come away with that, we'll have a drink on it in the evening.
A champion title is one of the most sought-after prizes at a show like this.
You need an animal.
Just a little bit of attitude, because they show themselves off better when they're out with the public.
The first Highland to get a pat on the rear will be the champion.
Stand up, come on.
Highland and
stand up. Stand up.
And Sandy's done it, beating her husband to first place with her blue-eyed girl, Jem.
So there we are, the ladies win again.
And Robert comes second.
Congratulations. All is well in the temporary household this evening. Thank you very much to the...
We didn't expect it, but we hoped for it. You go out to win. I've said before, I'm competitive. We come here to win. But if somebody else beats us, that's showing.
And the first was first and the second was second. How about that?
No, the wife was first and the old man was second.
Your wife was first, yes. What a wise man you are, Mr. Tebbury.
All the exhibitors that I've seen before me today have been a real credit to our industry. Thank you very much for giving them your support.
As a married man, it makes me even more happy that I came second, because it saves all the, oh, well, how did you come to beat me? Or how, you won it, my dear, so you're first, I'm second. I know my place.
Saved a divorce as well, letting the wife win. That worked very well.
Whoops, I've got to go.
The day's competitions are almost over, and Bridget has gone on to win a first place rosette with her youngest show cow, Georgina.
Great result. Very happy with that. Makes the job worthwhile.
And she made sure she shared the glory with the family.
It's the next generation working out what the rosette is and what to do with it.
I'm a proud mum and a proud grandmother.
To celebrate her mum's win, daughter Scarlett also got in on the act.
Hello, Scarlett. Here you go.
Pull it, Scarlett. There we go. Look, here we go. Scarlett's very first cow. Come on.
The competitions are now almost over. But there's just enough time for Gladiator to make his debut appearance at the final judging.
It's his first show. He's never been off the farm before. He's never seen any of this.
He will be taken into the ring by Bridget's helper, Andrew.
I'll be watching nervously from the sides. It's actually more nerve-wracking watching your animals being shown than it is on the halter of them.
So far, so good. At least they've managed to get Gladiator into the ring.
How old is it?
April.
Saying the overall block championship this year.
The nerves are starting to kick in. Bridget can only hope that her young bull will hold his own against the other experienced competitor. And Bridget's Gladiator takes first prize.
Well done. Well done. Yeah, well done. Back.
That's his first time in a show ring. He behaved pretty well, considering. Just looked a little bit nervous, a little bit apprehensive, but that'll really settle him down and put him on the good path. Good bump.
Well, it must be my care and love in touch with him, though. He's all right.
The Edenbridge and Oxted show is almost over for another year. And with judging finished, the families can finally relax. Our farmers have prepared for this day all year. With some of their hopes and dreams realised, they are all walking away winners.
Big smiles when you get a first prize, isn't it? Dancing. Yeah, we'll be celebrating tonight.
I'm a very happy girl at the moment. Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. I'm so chuffed.
For Bridget, the prizes won today will help secure the legacy of her fifth generation farm. Something she hopes to hand on to her children, Sam and Scarlett.
I've really enjoyed today, I always do. This is what I'm absolutely passionate about. The kids are having a whale of a time, and James has even enjoyed himself today.
That one?
Four flop, Samuel. A nice day out, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's a nice, yes, lovely happy day out.
And for overjoyed Sandy and Robert, winning will help sell their much-loved homebred cattle and provide a boost to their farm.
You've got to be proud about it. Take them right to the top of their class. That today is, it's a very proud moment. Fine.
The best moment for us today was Scarlett leading the cow for the first time. Look, here we go, Scarlett's very first cow. Come on.
It's a real proud parent moment. It comes naturally to her, and it won't be many years before she's really going to want a calf in that show ring herself.
Wow, Scarlett, would you like a cow for your birthday? Yes, please.
I feel 20 feet tall.
And hungry.
I can eat now.
Tonight will be a little bit of a party night.
Time for a pint.
Definitely time for more than one pint.
That's a first on camera.
Across the country, thousands of farming families work tirelessly around the clock.
Stop arguing, girls. Give over.
But there's one day each year when they get to leave the daily routine behind.
Right, here we come, Dorset.
These are show days.
A very, very warm welcome to Malpas Show.
When they come together as a community to showcase the fruits of their labour.
I just love showing my girls off.
And try to win prizes for their breed champions.
Smashed it.
And award-winning produce.
That's a really nice cheese, that.
It was very good, darling.
There will be highs.
That's what we want to see, red. Red is the best.
And lows.
She's not happy enough to go.
For the dedicated farmers who give everything to walk away a champion.
Fingers crossed.
Cattle farming is one of the most traditional forms of farming in the UK. Today we're meeting two families whose lifeblood is connected to their herds. Beef cattle farmers Robert and Sandy Tedbury from Sussex and Hertfordshire-based Bridget Borlase are busy preparing for one of the largest cattle championships in the country.
Come on, go on, Jen.
Winning awards helps boost the reputation of their livestock and their business, so there's a lot at stake.
Head up.
All year has been leading up to this event, and both families have their eyes on the prize. Rural Hertfordshire is home to hundreds of farms. And Bridget's family have been working this farm for five generations.
Always loved the cows. When I came back from school, my father said, well, that's where your passion is. You know, get on and you run that side of the business.
Having grown up on the farm, Bridget now lives there with her own family.
Wave to him, Sammy.
And five-year-old son Sam already has farming in his blood.
I'm already five, and when I'm six, I'm going to trim my sheep on my own. Is that right, Mum?
It is, Sam, yeah.
The farm has been in the family for 80 years, and breeding cattle has always been close to Bridget's heart.
My passion, right from when I was probably Sam's age, was pedigree livestock. Always loved the cows.
Bridget's grandfather, Bert, first introduced the Simmental cattle to the farm, and now Bridget has grown the much-loved herd to 250.
I spent more time reading the herd books of how the cattle were bred than I ever did studying at school.
To manage a farm this size takes much dedication, and Bridget is up at dawn every day, relying on her farm buggy to get her around.